The following information is provided by the National Comprehensive Cancer Network, known as NCCN. What is multiple myeloma? If you've been told you have a cancer called multiple myeloma, you probably have many concerns, such as, what exactly is multiple myeloma? Or, how does multiple myeloma develop? And how did I get it? And, for good reason, you might also want to know, what kind of treatments are available for it? So let's start with the first question. What is multiple myeloma? Basically, multiple myeloma is a rare type of cancer that begins in the bone marrow. That's the soft, spongy material inside your bones. And it's where blood cells are made. Healthy blood cells come in several types, one of which is a plasma cell. Plasma cells fight the infections and diseases caused by germs. They do that by releasing antibodies, which have the important job of seeking out and destroying those germs. One key reason plasma cells do this is because their actions are programmed by DNA, the body's instruction manual that tells our system how to function and grow. But in people with multiple myeloma, a small DNA mutation occurs, and that turns helpful plasma cells into harmful myeloma cells. What makes myeloma cells harmful? Well, they do things other cells don't do. They live much longer than they should. They make copies of themselves, which in turn makes many more copies, millions of them. And eventually, these myeloma cells build up so much in the bone marrow that they crowd out the healthy blood cells that should be there. What's more, the reason this cancer is called multiple myeloma is because myeloma cells can develop in multiple areas inside and outside your bones. It's also important to know that people with multiple myeloma didn't inherit this DNA mutation from their parents. The change in DNA happened all on its own. Doctors still don't know why this happens, but they're working on it. So this all leads to a very big question. How can multiple myeloma affect you? The answer is in a number of ways. Multiple myeloma can weaken your bones, often the bones in your back or your neck, which can cause pain and make those bones easier to break. It can also increase your chance of getting infections, because people with multiple myeloma make fewer germ-fighting cells. It also produces proteins that can damage your kidneys, and it can cause anemia, a shortage of red blood cells, which can make you feel weak and tired all the time. Fortunately, though, different kinds of treatments are available to fight what multiple myeloma may be doing to your body. One form of treatment is bone-building drugs, which can slow down the process of bone weakening. Another option is a bone marrow transplant, which can replace harmful myeloma cells with healthy cells. Still, other treatments for myeloma and myeloma-related issues include immunotherapy, targeted therapy, and chemotherapy, which can destroy cancer cells throughout the body, and medicines and radiation therapy that can help reduce pain. Finally, more work is being done every day to combat this disease as scientists continue to find new treatments that give people with multiple myeloma less pain, more hope, and more years to live. For more information and to access the full library of NCCN guidelines for patients online, please visit nccn.org/patient-guidelines or download the mobile app at nccn.org/apps. Please note, NCCN guidelines for patients are not intended to be a substitute for medical advice. Talk with your care team to determine the right course of treatment for you.